Our short-term memory is limited, and yet that is what we are most often using when we try to keep track of information on any particular web page or application page. There is often so much information in the websites that we use that we have trouble remembering what we have just seen or what we just scrolled through. It is for these reasons that we as designers should be judicious with how much information we put on screen and ensure that whatever we place on our screens is needed and relevant to the task at hand. In addition, our design should support helping users remember critical information by carrying that data over from screen to screen and having it available when necessary so we don't take up too much of our users' short-term memory. So let's review how short-term memory works. Now, short-term memory famously holds about 7 chunks of information. And these chunks fade from our brain after about 20 to 30 seconds. Since our short-term memory is so limited in both capacity and duration, we should try to create interfaces that focus on recognition rather than recall. Our brains are good at recognizing something we have seen before, but not as good at keeping new information in a ready state for usage, which is sometimes referred to as working memory. So how can we aid the user since memory is so short? So here are a few examples. As users navigate through a site, they may not remember all the links or navigation that they clicked on as they go back and forth. As they see more information on the screen, many will forget what they previously clicked on. So our solution should be to highlight navigation links that they clicked on, highlight navigation placement in the architecture, provide breadcrumbs. These design solutions help our users remember. Second, let's say a user wants to compare items on a website to make a choice. What's our solution? Well, we should provide a comparison table with all of the relevant data, all on the same screen, with easy-to-see, apples-to-apples comparisons, and highlight salient differences between the choices so that users don't have to remember the data. They can just see it all in one place. So one more example. Perhaps you have a site where users need to remember specific data, file names, codes, these types of things. What would our solution be? Well, our solution would be to have the system carry that information over for them so they don't have to remember themselves. The computer has an unlimited and hopefully perfect memory, so we should place the burden on the computer to help the user as an extension of their own memory. So let's try to capitalize on what we know about our memory and perception systems by providing clear information, carrying over information for our users, and prioritizing recognition over recall.